Facebook, YouTube, Pastor B, back at you. Molly Music in the background. Song is called "I Hate You." Of course, he's talking to the devil. I hate him too. So let's rock to it for a few seconds. And I got something good I gotta talk to you about. Come on, let's go. Listen, it's all right to get your thing on. Just some good music, y'all. Stop being so deep. Get your praise on. Come on. It's a wonderful day. Shout out to all our supporters. Nah, I've not stopped the Kingdom Vlogs. Just been a little busy moving into our new situation. But I'm here. And I'm ready to get this on tonight, alright? Come on, Molly. Y'all, excuse me, I told y'all I play music too, so I gotta get it on. Big shout out to all of y'all watching, every pastor, every member, every new love member, every Facebook supporter, my boo, April B. Alright. Let's get down to it. Cause I'm not gonna go the whole 10 minutes or whatever. Some of y'all ain't gonna watch the whole thing. So let me give y'all a little bit. So I asked y'all what should I talk about. And thank all y'all for making suggestions. And of course I'm gonna get to everything. But there was one in particular that was not put on my page, but rather it was in my inbox. I don't really know who this person is, but actually they told one of my members to have your pastor talk about this. And so I'm going to talk about it, right? And what they wanted me to talk about was they don't come to church because, or the reason why a lot of people don't come to church is because of so-called perfect people in church, or perfect preachers, perfect people on the front row, perfect women, perfect men. Let me bust your bubble. There are no perfect people in the pulpit. I know that by firsthand knowledge. No perfect people in the audience. People act like they're perfect, but they are not perfect. Bible says if you say you have no sin, you deceive yourself and you make God out of a liar. Because God is powerful and all-knowing, he will not be made a lie by the trickery and cunningness of man. Yeah? So let me go even further. I feel you, sir. I feel you, ma'am, who stay at home and find it hard to come to church and sit amongst hypocrites. The Bible says, the hypocrites, he said, you whitewashed tomb. He said, you look good on the outside, but on the inside, you're full of dead men's bone. I'm going to make somebody mad with this one. All of the super save, don't do nothing people. I'm going to make you mad with this because, ma'am and sir, you are a liar. Because all of us struggle with something. The Bible said, let us therefore lay aside every sin, and the weight that does so easily beset us. In other words, there were things that all of us deal with that doth so easily beset us. No matter how saved you are, no matter how much you love God, there was something that you struggle with that if God don't help you, you won't be delivered. Let me help you when I tell you that there are no perfect people in the pulpit. There are no perfect people in church. There are some people that are living saved. There are some people that are striving to be better than they are right now. A saint ain't nothing but a sinner. Saved by grace. A Christian is a sinner saved by grace. A Christian is someone that's trying to be Christ-like, trying to follow the example and the blueprint that Christ left when he walked on this earth 33 and a half years. Now, let me say this. I'm not bashing Christians because I'm a Christian. I love God, and I do the best I can to live for him. Now, even with that, My humanity sometimes causes me to not do everything as I ought to do. I get mad like anybody else. You know, I feel like cursing. Let me say it again so y'all won't think I messed up. I feel like downright cussing some people out at times. Because sometimes church folk get on your nerve. You know, my temper getting mad. I feel like fighting every once in a while. I'm going to keep it real. I'm a pastor. So if y'all going to talk about anybody, talk about me. I said it. You don't believe I said it? Rewind this back. Play it. I'll say it again. Sometimes I feel like cussing people out. Because, you know, people in church, they, you know, they act all extra sanctimonious. But then, you know, behind closed doors, there's something else. But because I love God and because I'm a mature individual, instead of me doing what I feel like doing, I choose to do right. I choose to keep my mouth closed. I choose to keep my temper down because it's not Christ-like for me to react how someone wants me to react or how the devil wants me to react. But that does not mean I'm perfect. I've struggled a lot, and the thing about it is everything that God has allowed to happen to me has made me better and stronger, and it has given me compassion now. Now I don't sit back and judge folk like, you know, oh, that dude did that, or he down bad, or she did that, or she going to hell. Nah, our God is a forgiving God who will forgive you no matter what you've done, no matter what you've struggled with. Our God is a forgiving God. And the Bible clearly says in Hebrews 4 and 15, it says, we don't have a high priest who cannot sympathize, that's an American Standard Version, who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses, but was tempted just as we were in all points, yet without sin. That's what the Bible says. Read it. Hebrews 4 and 15, it'll bless you. What it simply means is that he feels our infirmities. He's not so high until he'll understand what you're going through. But the Bible says the difference between Jesus and us is that even though he was tempted at all points, like us, see, a lot of folks don't want to talk about Jesus being tempted because you want to think, you know, Jesus never did anything, but Jesus was tempted. Back in those days, he was tempted. He was tempted by women. He was tempted by desires. He was tempted by anything because he was 100% human as well as divine. I didn't say that Jesus failed. I said that he was tempted. The Bible says he was tempted at all points, not some, not a few, not two or three, but A-L-L. Read it for yourself. All points, just like we are. But he did not yield to sin and temptation. All right? So even though he was tempted, he didn't yield. But a lot of us, because of our humanity and our unwillingness to be disciplined and walk in total obedience, a lot of us, we yield to things that we are confronted with day to day. And the devil is not crazy, y'all. The devil ain't going to bring you nothing you don't like. He's not going to bring you a short man if you like him tall. He's not going to bring you a larger lady if you like him small. He's going to bring you what you like because his motive operandus or motive of operation is to cause you to fall. Got to wrap this up. But listen, let me help you want to tell you this. A lot of people, preachers and men and women of God, they don't come to church because of us. Because, you know, we act like we have never did anything. We are not supermen. We are not superwomen. We are human beings. We have all failed. But the Bible says, and they overcame by the words of their testimony and the blood of the Lamb. In other words, he says, when I take you through something and you come out of it, it is not for you to judge anybody or to look down your nose at anybody. It is for you to tell them, listen, I know you're messing up. I know you failed. I know you're struggling. But listen, I've been through that. And God delivered me. And the same God that delivered me when I was struggling, drinking, smoking, whatever I was doing, the same God that can deliver you. Listen, let's get off all these high horses we got in. Walking around talking about, you know, we bishops and we pastors and we this. Listen, before you were all of that, you were still a sinner saved by grace. Come on, man. Love isn't love until you give it away. Show love, share love, and maybe, just maybe, sir and ma'am, you can call that young man to get out the corner. You can call that young girl to stop selling her body. You can call that alcoholic to put that bottle down. Let your light so shine that men may see your good works and not glorify you, but glorify your Father which is in heaven. Part two, coming tomorrow. Listen, people are not looking for perfection. They're looking for someone who has failed, but God got them up. And they're not ashamed to be real, to tell them that the same God that delivered me is the same God that can deliver you. This is Pastor B. I'm out. God bless you.